Everything worked out until the legal case. I sat in my cell and wrote down the evidence I had against all the people I had worked with. People I had been friends with for 10 years. The case was huge and caused a shock throughout the country. Salieri got life. Even some of his thugs got the chair. The shortest sentence was 8 years. I spent the whole time in a closed cell at a secret location, with no visitors. I didn't see Sarah or my little girl the entire time. In the end, it was worth it. Norman got us new identities and moved us to the other end of the U.S. I got work as a driver for a respectable company. We started a whole new life. This peace was only interrupted by the war, but we got through it.
Angelo.
Yes?
Mr. Salieri sends his regards.
You know, the world isn't run by the laws written on paper. It's run by people. Some according to laws, others not. It depends on each individual how his world will be, how he makes it. And you also need a whole lot of luck. So that somebody else doesn't make your life hell. And it ain't as simple as they tell you in grade school. But it is good to have strong values and to maintain them in marriage, in crime, in war. Always and everywhere. I messed up. So did Paulie and Sam. We wanted a better life, but in the end, we were a lot worse off than most other people. You know, I think it's important to keep a balance in things. Yeah, balance, that's the right word. Because the guy who wants too much risks losing absolutely everything. Of course, the guy who wants too little from life might not get anything at all.
One favor, guys, please. Not in the eyes.
Wait up. I can get us through here.
Leave him. We have to go.
Everyone's trying to get out. Look, Jesus, there's so many of them. Michael, I'm sorry. Aldo...
Aldo was family.
I can help. When we get back to New York...
I want you to make sure his mother's taken care of.
Okay, Mikey. Okay.
What do we do now?
Roth's plan for Cuba was the one thing keeping the families from tearing at each other's throats. We needed this country.
You don't think the rebels are gonna win?
They've already won, Fredo.
Michael, I mean, what do we do now? Our family, what about us?
Nobody was going to touch New York while Aldo was in charge. Everyone will want a peace now. His own men will probably turn on each other if they think it's to their advantage. It's only a few of them I trust anyway. But I trust you with my life. Dominic. I want you to be boss. And I want you to have your own family. I trust that you can run New York, Dominic. Will you do this for me?
Yes, Michael. I will.
Hide under the bed.
You gone nuts?
Hey, maybe we could hide in the shower.
That ain't the brightest idea I ever heard, kid. This is crazy.
Gotta do better than that, old timer. What the hell? Vito. Fuck.
Don't make this harder than it needs to be, Vito.
Damn thing's empty anyway. I'd always thought you'd be different from those other cocksuckers. That fat Derek Papalotto, Alberto Clemente, Leo Galante, but no. Always somebody waiting to fuck me.
Nobody forced you to get greedy. You could have sat back, been content, watched the money roll in. But nah, that wasn't enough for you.
Fuck you. I gave up everything for this life, everything. Look where I ended up. I deserve better. Fuck you.
Sal and Georgie are gone. And after all the shit we've been through, we run this city.
No, that's the kind of news you never get tired of hearing.
After all the bullshit, it's almost impossible for me to wrap my brain around the fact that we actually did it. You're a fucking saint, Lincoln. And I'm honored to know you.
So we finally gonna get our chance to make things right in this town. Bring a balance to things. Wasn't certain we'd ever actually get here.
It ain't personal.
What in the fuck?
You want to know what happened to Lincoln? After he killed those people he worked with, I realized that he was no different from Sal Marcano. So I put a bomb under his car.
The things he did, that what he turned into. I couldn't. I did some things in my life. Things that I regret. But killing Lincoln Clay isn't one of them. He carved his path out all on his own.
After everything he did, all the people he killed? No, no. A car bomb was too quick, too clean. You know, sometimes I wonder, that priest, Father James Ballard, he identified the body. Some nights when I'm down here, going over it all again, I swear I hear footsteps upstairs. It sounds like combat boots. Now, I know it's just this old house creaking and moaning. Well, when it happens, I can't help but wonder if it's Lincoln Clay coming to take what's left of my life.
Time ago, in another life, someone once told me that family is a man's Achilles heel, his greatest weakness. Maybe it was right, because everything I've done, both good and bad, I've done for my family. I've turned my back on people they thought were my friends. I've kept a lot of hard promises. I spent 8 years totally alone, trying to find myself so I could come home. A better husband, a better father, a better man. Now that I'm a lot older and just a bit wiser, I see that family is our greatest weakness, but it's also our greatest strength. Gets us out of bed in the morning. It lets us chase our dreams, even when they're moving too fast to catch. It keeps us from falling over when we're too tired to take another step.
Mr. Angelo.
Yes.
Mr. Salieri sends his regards.
Tommy!
That's okay. You're safe now. You're all safe. Remember that money, jobs, even best pals will come and go. But family is forever.